What's up, YouTube? This is MathLewis97, and welcome to episode number 5 of my SmackDown vs. Raw 2006 General Manager Mode. We are here in Concord, New Hampshire for this edition of SmackDown, April 26th. Let's get this show on the road. As you can see, the matches that I simulated earlier on, Christian versus Chavo Guerrero, one of the matches we've got lined up. Eddie Guerrero, the other half of the Tag Team Champions, alongside his brother Chavo, or cousin? I forget what their relationship is. It's uncle and nephew. That's how it is. I figured it out, guys. I remember things. So Chavo, one half the Tag Team Champions, defeats Christian. Will Eddie Guerrero be able to follow suit in his match with Rob Van Dam? A battle of the five-star frog splash. Well, just a battle of the frog splash. Eddie's just not a five-star. Although, you know, any match Eddie Guerrero's in is a five-star match. Let's be honest here. And if you're wondering why did I set Eddie to be clean there, you know, he's supposed to be a face, but they do, you know, he's the man that lies, cheats, and steals, so I don't know if I should have him be clean or dirty. Didn't quite figure that out just yet, but I don't know. Let me down in the comment section if that's such a big deal. Let me know down in the comment section what you think. Should I just play through a match like I normally would with Eddie Guerrero, or should I play to the fan reaction that it should be? I mean, it doesn't really matter in terms of the rivalries. They'll still progress and such, but anyways. So Eddie Guerrero and Chavo Guerrero, they've been looking mighty impressive as of late. They have been mowing down the competition in their tag team matches. And of course, being the tag team champions, I mean, we gotta start setting up that tag team division they're gonna be competing against. I mean, we've seen teams like Batista and Randy Orton, Big Show and Kane, Edge and Christian can even be paired together as a tag team. If there's any other ideas for potential tag teams that you've got in mind, that's going to be kind of like the question for this video. Who could I potentially pair up as a tag team to just add some new tag teams into that division? I mean, because with Edge and Christian, Edge is the U.S. champ at the moment. And between, you know, at the moment we've got Big Show and Kane going up against Randy Orton and Batista. So that's basically all our tag teams. I mean, I guess we've got Rene Dupree and Orlando Jordan, although they're more of the jobber tag team that just basically will lose to everybody. But, I mean, I could make them a tag team, I guess, if you really wanted me to do that, if you wanted me to try to push them forward. But for the moment, I just kind of need those superstars who are going to be the fodder, who are just going to lose to everybody, going to put them over. Guys like Tajiri who get put in that obligatory handicap match where it's just basically to get the other superstars over, get them winning some matches. Because I can't abuse the schedule like you can in SVR 2008. No, that game you can, you know, build everybody up and you can get them all up to like 80 popularity and such. And then you got yourself a nice working show, but that is not the case in 2006. No, your superstars, the only way you can raise popularity is to win your matches or compete in some really awesome rivalries, which we're doing that at the moment, but not everybody can be in a rivalry. We need some other way to build up our talents, to get them up into a status where they can put on some decent match ratings and compete for titles. We can't have somebody who's 26 overall be our World Heavyweight Champion. That's just not going to fly. Not even the United States Champion, not the Tag Team Champion, not the Cruiserweight Champion. We can't. We need more people up in at least like the 50s, the 60s in popularity to compete for titles. That's basically like my minimum. Unless it's in a championship squash match where it's basically just to get a better rating. Like I did with Daivari and Van Dam a couple of weeks ago. And, well, two episodes ago. Was it last episode? No, it was last episode. I did it several times. They competed against each other. But, you know, you get my idea. I'm not actually, you know, this is kind of the game I would like to do 2007 GM mode as well, which will kind of build off of this one. So this is kind of the game mode where I'm just sort of trying to remember how the older former GM mode works. Oh, look at that sequence right there. Van Dam rolling over the back of Eddie and then drop kicked him in the face. What a beautiful combination that was. Van Dam looking pretty good right at the moment. Got control of this one. But Eddie now appears to have gained the advantage as he's up on the shoulders of Van Dam. What's he looking to do here? Look at that. Oh, DDT. Van Dam face first into the mat. And now Eddie off the top rope was thinking elbow drop, but Rob Van Dam rolled out of the way. And now looking for some striking form of the Rolling Thunder as opposed to the, I don't know. I think it's weird that they would throw the Rolling Thunder in as just a throwaway move like that. Like, that's just, when your opponent's down, he'll just roll to him. As opposed to, you know, he's also got the other grappling move where he'll hit the Rolling Thunder. I don't know if I really like that much, but whatever. I'm not here to criticize this game. I'm here to play it and enjoy it. So as we can see, Eddie Guerrero with the STF locked in, but Van Dam was able to crawl to the ropes. And that is something I really like about this game, is the whole, you know, when you're in a rope break, or not a rope break, when you're in a submission hold and the rope break is on, you got to get to a certain point and then they'll go crawl over to the ropes. I think that's pretty cool. I mean, the way they do it now in newer games, that's pretty cool as well, where, you know, you got to crawl over there. But then again, the submission system is just, I don't know if they've ever really had a great submission system. At least the one that they have now is kind of in balance. This one, I feel like the one they have in 06, 07, I always kind of liked that submission system. So when they started the Breaking Point submission system, I like that, because the way this one goes, it's not quite as imbalanced. You know, you can kind of battle with each other. Although, I guess it's still basically the same principle, so. I don't know. I always like the kind of button mashing, but then again, I guess that's not great for controllers. Eddie off the drop kick goes for the cover. Van Dam with the kick out, able to get the shoulder up. As now Eddie Guerrero, countered by Van Dam. Oh, nice shot to the back of the head of Eddie Guerrero. But now Eddie delivered a right hand there. Eddie off the ropes, but Van Dam able to sidestep out of the way. Now Eddie, he ducks behind. Look at this. Oh, roll up on Van Dam, but that's a rope break. Van Dam too close to the ropes. He was able to get out of that one. And a nice snapmare takedown there from Rob Van Dam. As look at this. Oh, ducks again. Oh, look at that. Look at that combination right there. Well, that wasn't even a combination, just a sequence of moves. Eddie, he ducked the initial attempted kick by Van Dam. But then Van Dam, he caught Eddie off guard with that second one. And now look at this. Inside cradle by Eddie Guerrero. One, two. No, kick out by Van Dam. At just the right time, Van Dam stays alive. Here's Eddie now. Counter by Van Dam. Is this matchup's looking pretty good between these two? They're going back and forth. Although I do think the matches in, you know, this year, in this game, as I guess some of the older matches would be, it's kind of slow paced a little bit. This matchup actually goes on for quite a long time. So if there ever are any points in these matches where I gotta skip, that's why, because I don't want the videos to drag on unnecessarily. Look at Eddie Guerrero right now. He's looking for the Three Amigos, the triple rolling suplexes right there. And Eddie could be thinking, he could be feeling froggy, going to the top rope, looking for the frog splash, but Van Dam, he's well out of the way of that one. Or maybe he wasn't. As, now look at this, Eddie Guerrero, well, he's not wasting any time. The lasso from El Paso is locked in. This slow motion is so unnecessary. Rob Van Dam's got the ropes there. That's a rope break. But Eddie Guerrero, you know, he's gone through all this trouble. He's really locking it in there. That's a four, and referee using the count. Referee. Eddie using the referee's count to its full potential. He's using it as much as he can without getting disqualified. Van Dam once again with that beautiful kick. I didn't really get that slow motion with the submission hold. Because it's like, you know, I want to make this guy tap out. How about now? You know, it just really kind of dragged on. I didn't really see the point in that. But whatever. I don't know. This game came out almost 10 years ago now. It's almost the 10-year anniversary of this game, which is also kind of why. Oh, that was a nice neck breaker. I want that move. I want that move in the newer game. That neck breaker looked freaking cool. But, another nice. See, look at Van Dam. He's just got these epic kicks. Look at this backflip into a moonsault. Oh, cartwheel into a moonsault. A backflip into a moonsault is basically a moonsault into a moonsault. But whatever. Actually, no, it's not. It's, never mind. I'm having an argument with myself. This is what I've digressed to. Anyway, as I was saying with, this game almost did come out 10 years ago. So that's basically, you know, the timing of this series just works out because, you know, 2006. Wait a minute, backslide by Van Damme. 1, 2, 3, Rob Van Dam knocks off Eddie Guerrero with the backslide. And what a great matchup that was between these two competitors. The Cruiserweight champion, in the end, defeats one half of the tag team champions. So Rob Van Dam, he continues his winning ways with the big victory over Eddie Guerrero. And we are now going to move on to the main event, six-man tag team matchup. And yes, I can choose between Masked and Unmasked Kane. I'm going to be kind of deciding which one I want to go with. I might just kind of alternate between the two. Or if you guys want me to select a certain attire, if you would rather have Kane be masked, have him be unmasked, maybe perhaps work it into some sort of storyline or something. Not too sure what I want to do with that yet, but it is an option. So just to throw that out there, if you want to see Masked Kane or Unmasked Kane, we'll figure that out. As you can see, this is a six-man tag. Kurt Angle, Batista, and Randy Orton teaming up to take on The Big Show, Kane, and Triple H. So, of course, we get to mix up some rivalries here as we've got The Big Show, Kane, versus Batista-Randy Orton rivalry, and then we've got the Kurt Angle versus Triple H rivalry thrown in as well, along with a main event hype promo. So this should be getting a pretty good rating. And basically, the strategy I figured out on what to do with those like promos that you can throw in, like it was in 08, where you could have like an interview or match hype, title match hype, whatever the case is. What I've been doing, I've been using the main event hype and an advertising promo. That's how I've been using those promos to my advantage so far. You can see Big Show, he hit a chokeslam on Kurt Angle, but Batista was there to break it up before anything could really come out of it. And, I don't know, I was going to say something, but I lost my train of thought, so I apologize for that. Big knee right to the face there by Triple H. So, yeah, there was the option with Kane. I don't think anybody else really has a second attire that I can remember. I know there were some you can unlock, like there was a John Cena one, and I think a Carlito attire, if I'm correct. Can't quite remember. But those were ones like in the WWE shop. And they have some weird, you gotta complete like challenge mode or something, and I don't know how I feel about that. That's a bit more of a commitment than I'm really willing to commit to. I am progressing, trying to unlock some legends and whatnot, but I don't think I'm going to be bringing any of them in until after Judgment Day, after our first pay-per-view, so that way we can get our rivalries and stuff we got going finished up, we can wrap that up. And then I've got the idea in my mind for the potential tournament, as Kane just clotheslined the referee, but no disqualification there, so whatever. But as I was saying, with the legends, I'm going for Bret Hart. I know that was one of them. Somebody suggested Andre. The other options, I know there was like the Junkyard Dog. There were a couple that were like at the moment that are already there. I just need to buy them. Whereas there are other ones I gotta complete like season mode, a certain pay-per-view or whatever the case may be. Oh, what a German suplex right there by Kurt Angle. And I love how in like some of these older games, how that German suplex is just drop them on the back of their head. It's like, if that would happen in you know, a real ring, I feel like they would die. I feel like it would just be like, broken neck, you're done. It's just an awesome animation. I always thought that was kind of, it just looked really painful. It's like, oh my god, they're getting dropped on the back of their head. There's no way they're gonna get up from that. And then they do. So it just shows that, you know, these WWE superstars, they are machines in there. But unlike in 2008, where they literally were machines because I turned off injuries and they could not get injured at all, this year we've got all the settings set. So we have our injuries, our the rivalries, there is no championship contender that I can change, but there is also the morale. So I'm going to have to be wary of that. I can't afford to let people get too upset. by losing or not getting title opportunities, whatever the case may be, as long as I'll be able to make that work. But I know in 2008, that whole morale deal could really get kind of fishy. Like, you could give somebody a title opportunity, and then they're like, give me another title opportunity, even though you just gave them a title opportunity. Sometimes I guess it's for the world title. I don't know what they even want, but it doesn't really specify. But Kane off there hits the last ride powerbomb, but Randy Orton's there to break it up. And I know that's just like a generic powerbomb, but I figured that I always thought of it as like the last ride. Plus, I really like that powerbomb animation. But, I mean, the fact that Kane, he's like Undertaker's brother, he's got the chokeslam, the tombstone, so I always just assumed that that powerbomb was like Kane's last ride. So, if you're ever confused, like, why are you calling that the last ride? That's not what that is. Well, to me, that is what that move is. That is Kane's last ride. So, deal with it, as Batista would say. And look at Batista. Oh, pile driver to the Big Show right there. That looked like a pretty safe pile driver, but even a safe pile driver is a very dangerous move. So Big Show's in a lot of troubles. Batista really taking it to the Big Show right now, working on that giant tree trunk-like leg, but Big Show's able to escape that submission hold. As we can see, Kurt Angle now. He's going after Triple H. He's got him rolled up here. Referee, though, what is the referee even doing? He was just, like, standing there, yelling into space, instead of counting the pinfall. These referees, man, I don't know what are they on? Who's paying these guys? They're not doing a very good job. Whether it's the crooked referees who just beat up everybody, or don't even call disqualifications, I don't know. I always loved how, like, I mean, I would play some of the... I didn't do a whole lot of it, but I did play games like Day of Reckoning and whatnot on the Nintendo GameCube. And I love how if you would attack a referee for so long, they would fight back. And you could literally have a match with the referee. And you would probably end up losing the match because you're fighting two people. But Triple H, wait a minute, cover on Batista. And Big Show just delivered a big boot to the referee. And there's a disqualification. So Kurt Angle's team wins. That's the match. Good job, guys. Good job. Good job, everybody. That'll definitely get us some fans from Raw. So as we can see, Raw had the Backlash pay-per-view, so that came out in a 3-star rating. So it looks like JBL is the WWE champion. Well, that's news. So Monday Night Raw, with that pay-per-view, they're definitely going to get a ratings boost this week. Let's take a look. 2.5-star show rating for Monday Night Raw. And their main event was 3.5. A fatal four-way for the WWE Championship between JBL, Hogan, Cena, and The Undertaker. We got a 2.5-star show as well, with our main event coming in at 4 stars. That's what I'm talking about. Only in the first month, we've already got a 4-star match. That's great. That's awesome. But then, as we can see, Backlash did get the 3-star rating. You can see the matches going on there. A steel cage triple threat for the WWE Championship between JBL, Taker, and Cena, coming in at a 4-star match to main event the pay-per-view. So it's understandable that Raw would get the ratings boost for this week. So it looks like we're going to have to go all out next week. We can see some of these superstars. They want title shots. And we've also got these guys, Orlando Jordan and Rene Dupree. They want to win. And seeing as they've got not awful popularity in comparison to someone like Tajiri, we might want to get them that victory. When it's Tajiri, he can jump ship to Raw. That'll only benefit me. But with anyone else at the moment, we'll try to keep him happy for now. But that is it for this episode. We'll take a look at the rivalries as they have updated. We've got a few there. Not sure which ones I'm going to run with just yet, but obviously the ones that have the 3-week thumbs up, we're going to continue. That is it for this episode. Thank you all for watching. I hope you enjoyed. And until the next episode, keep on YouTubing.